my right is a man who, when the true history of the 19th, 20th, and 21st century culinary history is written, it will squarely set on Andrew Zimmern.
The last chapter.
The last.
Z.
But you came in the early 2000s on television. Your advocacy, your teaching, your social media presence, AKA communication, and then the style of storytelling literally changed an industry.
First of all, to the thousands, tens of thousands of storytellers who've been doing this for the last 40, 50 years in all kinds of media who never popped because they weren't a commercialized commodity, we owe them the biggest debt because it's on their shoulders that people like Bourdain and myself and Alton Brown and whoever else you choose to throw in there stands. Then you have all the people whose stories, whose foods, you know, without whom I wouldn't have had anything to talk about, right? And they're the real stars too. And I'm just glad that I'm included. I'm glad that I am able to make a difference. I want to make more of a difference. I mean, that's always been my focus. It's not been about the commercial side of what I do is great, and it pays a lot of the bills. But you know, the advocacy, the social justice work, now I can use my platform to go try to change, you know, food policy on Capitol Hill. I can go and try to be the change that I want to see in the world, because we have some very, very serious issues to confront in the food world right now.
Talk about how you were forced to evolve and some of your Capitol Hill work, the Restaurant Coalition and so forth.
It really started about 5 years ago. I was at an event and there were three or four of us who were all telling old New York City restaurant war stories, and several of us had worked together around there. Tom Colicchio was there, Jose Andres was there, four or five others. So we all agreed we need to be more focused on solutions on Capitol Hill. Laws matter in this country, and we need to change the laws. We would see each other every 6 weeks at some big gala where we would raise $1 million and it would get thrown into a bucket to help, you know, hunger relief or what, you know, whatever the issue was. But that bucket had, you know, $2 million holes in it. So the $1 million just keeps going through. Once a couple of us who were a little noisier made some noise, we were able to engage with everyone across America. Because at every level, three people were on a call, then five, then seven. And then there was a core group of about 12 to 17 of us that started the Independent Restaurant Coalition. And we had singleness of purpose, one goal. We're gonna pass a law on Capitol Hill that's gonna backstop restaurants. Once we could get restaurants backstopped, we will move on to whatever the next issue is, and we will be using our muscle on Capitol Hill. The late Senator Paul Wellstone, my mentor, used to say all the time, we all win when we all win, and nothing could be truer. We all win when we all win, which is why it's so vital that we all play on the same team. And it's why the divisiveness in our country right now has to be healed. We need bigger, I mean, we have big tables here. We need bigger tables, you know? We need to sit down and talk to people who we think we don't understand and find a way forward.
Thank you, my friend.
Thank you. I appreciate it very much. It's great that you do this and that you have these conversations with people. I'm very grateful. Thank you for allowing me a platform to talk about things that I think are very, very important.